Corinthians 15:10 says, but whatever I am now, it is all because God poured out on a special, out a special favor on me and not without results. So God gives you something that the Heere speciale guns op ons uitgestort. Kan iets wonderliks gebeur, for I have worked harder than any other apostle, says Paul. He says, but yet, it was not I, but God was working through me by His grace. Sy genade. So vir ons hart het vandag wonder, so hey, I can do this right. Look, without Christ we can do nothing. That's as simple as this. Wat kan het met wat die Heere binnen in ons doen? Soos ek gesê het, dit is persoonlik vir Paulus, en dit is persoonlik. So, personal, it's Jan, it's Jesus and me. And this is the inleiding van verleden die ook, wat is volgende gegeven, en die jongens, wat nie van soek kan opvang. Now, I want to take on part 2 this morning, if you want to get a look at part 1, part 1 is loaded on YouTube. Everyone is really good at what he does. And now you put that on YouTube already, so part 1 is there, if you want to go back, if you want to have time, and part 2 will probably be on tomorrow morning. Because he does understand his day on the slap of the and I light it off. Now, what do you for what say? Deal 2. He came into this world. And what have I made of this? Paul said, I said, he found Paul. As a guy, I think Paul is a fool. Paul is a fool. He's a fool. Die Heere kom vandag in hierdie wêreld en hy vind vir ons al wat hier sit. Maar wat is ons toe, wat is ons toestand wat hy ons invind? What condition does God find us in? You see, that is key. That's why I say, I can't do it in two. It's doing one, I can do it in two. So this morning, we have certain conditions that God finds us in. En ons het, op ons kalender, so ek op die jongens gesit, en daarom wil ek nie te maken met die samme jou, so hy nie raak te duiden, door die stad. I just want to love Jesus, man, that's what I want to do. Is dat die sê, dat op ons onderdak is dit nou, volgende week, paasdag week, what it would you like. But the fact of the remember is, that this has happened in history. There was such thing as a crucifixion. Jesus died on the cross for you and me. But Jesus died on the cross for you and me because he found us in certain conditions of our life. And those conditions would have carried on. If Jesus didn't die to come and counteract that thing, we would have never had a future. And that's what we want to touch on this morning. And friend, you're sitting before Christ this morning. And there's a few things that I'll touch on this morning. Apart. And I want you to make it personal this morning for yourself. But ek het gesê ons van daardie tyd gaan ons brood breek en gaan ons nagmaal gebruik. It's important that you understand that Jesus died on the cross not for the up next year, but for you. Dis die persoon wat jy kan wees. But what condition did he find you? That's the first one. I was down. Down. Can you realize this? We got a downer story in your life. You've been down. So yes, when you were down, he saw you and he came to lift you up. He said, come on, this is my name. Can I hear it? Can I hear it? Is it? Hans Albert made a scripture here in Openbaring in verse 5. It says, and from Jesus, he is the faithful witness to these things. What things? I'm down. He's the witness. To your depression. To your state of mind. To your negativeness. He is the witness. The first to rise from the dead. He was. He rose from the dead because he saw that. And he knew people will go through that. And he came to overcome that. Hello? Someone said hello. That's what he did. The scripture says that in the ruler of all the kings of the world, all glory to him, who loves us and has freed us from our sins. Shedding his blood for us, he has made us a kingdom of priests for God, his Father, all glory and power. A kingdom of priests for the kingdom of God. Now, if I know there are so many people that I've met who have been down, depressed, negative. And Christ takes them out. When they become free, they're not in the kingdom of God anymore. But they were made, the Bible says, they were made, they were put together as that kingdom of priests. Also, tot bekering gekomen, we should be known as a kingdom of priests. Because when we were down, He lifted us up. That was our condition. But we come to the communion table week in and week out. And we drink the blood and we take from the body. And we never acknowledge when I was down and lifted me up. Who do you see? Do you know what And even, You also say, see what I say, when I was down, He lifted me up. Jesus loves us, man. And so, in that abundant love, what did He do? He washed us from the guilt and the power of the sin that was in our life with His own blood, and He made us kings. He brought us into a place, and the priest, He made, these have become heads, but they become erfgenamen van die koninkryk van God. Sy kinders. Die wat hier sit vanoggend. Sy kinders. En ons word die priesters van God die Vader wat op die troon sit. Die liefdevolle priesters wat mense wat saam met ons beweeg verander raak en die leer van die koninkryk van God in hulle in te trek. Nie te oordeel nie. Christ lewe. Christ. Christ love. That's why He said in Matthew 7 verse 1, judge not and you will not be judged. That's what He came to do. Allowing us to continually offer ourselves as a holy, living sacrifice. Guys and ladies, soveel liefde. Hy tel ons op. Dat is waarom te kom kom, dat is gedierig en ook kom dink, ek is gedierig hier en ook dankie te kom sê. John Wesley said this, he says, we need to thank Him continually for His glory, His love and His redemption. Continually. Kom ons geraak aan die onredelik stil vir oggend hier waar ons is. En denk ek hier aan die toestand wat die waarste God hier gevind. Was hy af? Hoe jy daar? Was jy negatief? Was jy ten neergedruk? Dan het jy vir uitgewerkt. Jy sê, verdank jy met Jesus. Jy kan help ons sê. Jy sê, Paulus het dit verstaan. Ek en jy as Christene moet dit ook verstaan. En jy sê vir my, Pieter, maar dit is miskien moontlik dat so'n toestand by my was. En toe die Heer my uit het gelig het, wat het hy gedoen, hoe het hy my gesien, omdat hy jou ken, omdat hy sy skepping is, omdat hy sy seun en sy dochter is, omdat hy lief is vir jou, omdat hy elke haar op jou haar op jou kop het hy vertel, hy het jou gesien groei in jou moeder, toe sy zwanger geword het met jou, hy weet wie jy is, you be marked down, you record it, in the kingdom of heaven, and when you were tired and weary and stikkend in die soort, in die hieltje. The Psalm writer says in Psalm 40 verse 2, he says, He lifted me out of a pit of despair, out of the mud, out of the mire. He took me, He brought me up. Ek weet nie waar jy in het sien, hy lief op in die lewe is na, but that speaks to me, because that's where I was, eh? And when He picked me up, when He brought me out, I came to this thing and I said, Lord God, I found you. What's going to happen now? And He carries on in the scripture and He says, I put your foot, Peter. I took you, I put your foot on solid ground. And I steadied you. So you need to bring back and forth to follow me. Nie hier na toe wikker, daar na toe veeg nie. Jy is nou stelselmatig, jy is vast. You're on for it. Come forward, come to me. Come and walk along with me. Because He saw me sinking deeper and deeper into sin and death. But before it happened to me, before I died, en hy wil dit doen met hier en elk van sy kinders. He loves us to pieces. Why? Because because he's a God, the scripture says, who is rich in mercy. And he loves us every single day, every single night. As they so slap the body of us, our slap is lifted. That's just the way he loves us. And the Bible says, even though we were dead because of sin, he gave us life when he raised Christ, his son, from the dead. Because it's by God's grace that we have been saved. Somebody said God's grace. That we have been saved. Unmerited favor. When you were down, and he came and he lifted you up. You say, ach, what did I say back then? What happened when you were sick? When he came and he found you in a condition of what we're speaking about, and we say this is Jesus and me, but if it's Jesus and me, then all these certain things are going to take place. And it's just the fast when I was down and he lifted me up. Hey, man, like a jaw, that's Jesus and me. But then there was a time when he came and he saw, yo, Peter, you sick. You need healing. And when I'm sick, because I don't know Christ, I'm sick of the stuff that the world feeds me every single day. I'm sick of all this happening around me. My brain becomes so sick that I begin to redeneer of ek kerk toe gaan of moet ek nie kerk toe gaan nie, hoeveel mense gaan en hoeveel mense gaan nie, en as na 50 is, dan kan ek ons nou nie meer ingaan. You see, my mind is, the world takes our mind and pulls it from our body and starts working with us, and because the devil has got free hands in the world here, all these things start jumping out, and so what we do is our bodies become sick. And instead of turning to Christ, because the word says that when we were sick, he came to heal us. Ons raak net erger en erger. En ons raak negatiewer en negatiewer. En wat ons doen? Last part of that verse, Isaiah 53, verse 3, verse 5 says, and with his stripes we were healed. King James Version says, with his stripes we were healed. When he got beaten to death before he died on the cross, by his own stripes, every stripe that he pulled across his back, was the healing for you and me. The healing for you and me. I want to read this verse to you in the Bible. And maak het een persoonlijke ding saam met my volgend. For he was wounded for my transgressions, for the living of the earth. I am what Jesus is. You see, the prophet, the creator of God. And the prophet profiteer you good in Isaiah 53. Jaren voor Jesus op a Christ staat. Jaren na in die klare die Christ gestaat, dit is ek en jy nog. Maar die woord staan nog vast. Die woord gaan nergens heen nie. Die profesie staan nog vast, die profesie gaan nergens heen nie. Die profesie het gekom en die profesie het waar geword. En wat het ons gedoen met die ware profesie wat uitgespreek is en wat nagelos is, is geskiedenis in die annale, sodat ek en jy nog steeds elke dag daaraan kan vasklou en leef. Wat is die woord sê? He was crushed for our wickedness. Amplified Bible says for our sin. Our injustice and our wrongdoing. Stay on, man. The punishment required for our well-being fell on him, who was Jesus. And then by his stripes or his wounds, we are healed. So I seen, Peter, I seen, yes, you go late. There's a stick bullet in you. Wat ben jy klein bietjie vreemd? Ek is verlore, ek moet jou gaan soek, ek gaan jou vind. En hy vind vir my, en hy die precies waar ek af is, en ek is negatief, en ek weet nie, ek is moeg, man. Ek tel my op. Dus zegt iemand, je was je niet mocht, je was je niet negatief. Ik zie het dan. That's why I died. I sent my son to die for you. So then in your sickness you can have a second chance, man. A second bite of the apple. Lekker. Put that in your Bible and smoke it. What have you heard? If it's Jesus and me, surely it's got to be part of my life every day. She's secretly with him. You see, but even that for me. You see, before I met Jesus, that's exactly how he found me. Nothing more than that. My sonde is dan nog aan die kruis vastgehouden. Want ek het toegelaat dat hy met Jesus gekom het. Die dag dat ek hom toelaat, to say for me, you understand the lost part by my stripes and my young son. And it's like I was never up, son. You see, my heart, my kop, and my fears was in line gekom het. With the Heere. If your heart and your mind and your soul do not line up to the will of God will never happen in your life. Your mind, heart, and soul has got to line up to why Jesus died on the cross, why God sent him. And last time I was here, I said that he came as the advocate to plead our case before God. So he seen for me, and he seen what I could do, and he goes to his father, and his father said, I've had enough of Peter, there's no such thing. No. Don't. I plead. I died for that young man. Praise God for the youngness. So when I line my heart, mind, and soul up to apply the full meaning of Jesus, what happened? My wicked part of my life, my slechte gedeelte van my lewe, became band-aids of salvation for the love of Jesus Christ. And he turned around and he said, from a sick, sin-sick person in need of a great physician, he had become new before him and thanked God for the greatness and allowed Jesus Christ, his son, to heal me from that. You see, people that aren't sick don't need a doctor. You don't go to the doctor when you're not sick. You go to the doctor when you're sick. So the dealers, and then Jesus said that while he was teaching his disciples, he said this, he said, those who are healthy have no need for a physician. Not at all. I don't need one for a doctor. Only those who are sick. I did not come to call the righteous. Hallo, I don't go to the left. For anyone who has this. I came to call the sinners. I came to call those that are doing wrong, those that recognize their sin. Those that are all humble, who come stand humbly before me, those that don't want forgiveness for what they've done wrong. That's why I came. I'm that doctor. You see, Paul said, my brother was given to me, and he said, my message, I will a gesond makingsproces hier gaan. I will gesond word. That's why I say to you that God is loving, but God doesn't force himself on anybody. But he's come, and he's found us in certain conditions of our life. And I've gone through two of those already. And a very clever man by the name of Charles Spurgeon said this: no sprinkling can wash out sin. No confirmation can confer grace. No masses can propitiate God, which just needs one of favor. Your hope must be in Jesus, Jesus smitten, Jesus bruised, Jesus slain, Jesus the substitute for sinner. Whoever believes in him is healed, but all other hopes are alive from the top to bottom. I get it. And who better to say it than Charles Spurgeon? So he is. So we carry on our journey. On what condition did God find us in? And if I ask you right now, friend, what condition did God find you in? Or what condition does God find us in this morning? While we're seated in this place of worship? Was it persuaded against the commonwealth? Daar's 'n woord, ons weet dit is Paasfees. So I'm going to say these things this morning because I believe that if we want to celebrate Easter, if we want to celebrate the risen Christ, it's not the day, it's the risen part, it's the Sunday part. That's what we want to really celebrate. Is when he came from death to life. When he overcame this world for you and me. Where he said in John 16, 33, where he said, this world can have all these troubles, but I'll overcome this world. And he could do. From who find things? Erken ons hier goed in ons lewe? Have we given him the right to speak directly into our lives? Have we let him speak? Because as we go into this period of where we are now on our calendar, and Easter comes, and next Sunday pops up, and we celebrate Easter. Before we celebrate Easter. You see, when we finish here this morning, I want us to break bread together, as I said just now. Because that's what he did before he died, man. And when we use that bread and that wine this morning, we've got to ask ourselves, what condition is he finding me in? Why is that going to be floating with you? Who's that going to be floating with you? Because you see, some of us, and we were all there, and we didn't even be in the market, we didn't even be in the market, we didn't even be in the market. Ek het die Here ontmoet en ek het 'n ongelooflike goeie ontmoeting met die Here gehad wat tot bekering gekom het. En dit is God was my tool. Alles wat drone om my wat so. En dit is die volgende ene. I was far away, but he came to bring me near. The death of Christ on the cross het gesien ek is ver. En when I understood, ek het tot op tele gekom en ek het erken wat ek was en waar ek was, toe dryf ek vir. En in hierdie wat ek ver van die kruis al weg was, het hy my gesien. And because I started this personal relationship with Christ and it was Jesus and me, he just brought me closer. And he brought me to a place where I could feel his heartbeat. Where I can understand who he is and what he means to me in my life. And when I die, I'll meet him one day. Praise God for that. Ephesians 2:13 says, but now you have been united with Christ Jesus. Once you were far away from God, but now you have been brought near to him through the blood of Christ. My friend, the death at Calvary gave you and I the right to be drawn closer. Nou, as jy nou is, moenie sê jy het gekry by die historiese. Ek is 'n Christen. Dan moet ek nie en jy as 'n Christen is, moet ons seker teen Jesus Christus ons posisie vind, because the Bible says, I have through his death on the cross, I have been drawn near to him. Hoe ver is ek nou? Daarvan af. Because if we're far off, we're separated from God. Ons is verwyder van God. As ons ver is weg van die Here. As ek 'n probleem het om te gaan aanbid en ek het altyd 'n verskoning. Is ek weg? Is ek ver? Alleen, because I was drawn closer. My alienation, ek kan nie sê hoe. My alienation causes a spiritual distancing from Jesus, from God, from my Maker, from where I'm going to go one day. But there's no money in my living. It really means I have no part with God. But through the blood of Christ, I am brought closer. Very, very close. I can choose how close I want to be to God. Omdat ek nie daai merk nie. Wie van ons was al vasgevang deur die planne van die duivel? How many of us have been caught captive by Satan? And when we're caught captive by Satan, guys, ladies, it works this way. If it works this way, then if we are caught captive by Satan, what do we do then? What's the next one? Because you see, Satan only knows one thing, and that's sin. So when we're caught by him, we do sin. So the Bible says that when he came, again, when he came, he found me in that condition. He found me in a situation where I was a captive of Satan, because all I was doing was sinning there. And because it's Jesus who found me, and the death on the cross saved me at the point where I accepted him. He said, look, I found you. I see you. I see you full of sin, Peter. But I came to set you free, God. John 8:36. He came to set us free. The captive that I was, he says in 32, he says that I will know the truth. And it's the truth that will set me free. You see, before I was held by Satan, I didn't know the truth. I thought I knew the truth. Ek het ook wel net so aangeploeter en gaan geploeter en aangeploeter. Wat gebeur in vandag se lewe? Mense ploeter met aan, mense gaan kerk, mense gaan sonnaskool toe, mense gaan kerkassie toe, mense, dis ons ploeter net vorentoe toe aan. But then you see why we ploeter in on, what happens then? Then Satan beats his claws into us all the time and we start saying. And when Jesus came and he died on the cross, because God will have enough of that at that point in time. And he, what did he do? He said, I sent my son into this world so that when you receive him, you will know the truth. And the truth of my son's death on the cross will set you free, man. That's what it is. That's near me, that's under me. So he says the following. When the son sets you free, you'll be free indeed. Don't follow any thoughts. Don't follow Jesus. When I was a prisoner in the house of Satan, Christ came and he set me free. So it's not like afraid, but I self-evident, we had to, we need to ask Jesus, we need to pray and say, you know, ek wil terugkom na u. Ek wil nie vasgevang word in die bondage wat in die lewe in die heilige Christus is. But this whole world at the moment is, if you look at it, I mean, if you look at what's happening in his life today, everything is a lust, everything is a sin. There's nothing really happening. I'm a goody two shoes, man. This gave me this morning. I probeer. And almal van ons kom in argumenten met mense, and almal van ons is jammer oor die ding wat ons nou net gesê het, wat ons nie moes gesê het. But you see, the blood of Christ has come, and if you come and acknowledge that immediately, there's. As a good God, my brother. But this, I have command on your knuckles. Before I get from my, I quit, just ask yourself, how have I been living my life the last 5 days? And why would God bless you continually if you're not blessing God continually, friend? This is a man. See, this is a rocket science, man. When he finds us in this condition, it breaks his heart. Hy wil ons nog uitmaak. Hy wil ons groter maak. Why does he want to take this bondage and break it? Because you see, if you're doing more for the world than what you're doing for Christ, surely I can make this statement. If I'm doing more for the world, I'm alive to the world and I'm dead to Christ. Sure. Maar as ek meer doen vir God en minder vir die wêreld beteken dit, ek lewe vir God. En ek is dood vir die wêreld. And you see, when Jesus came and he looked down and he found us in a situation and he said, wow, dude, you lost. You're going, you're walking away. And I've been a lot about those things I've lost on to those things. Hierdie is die mooiste gedeelte daarvan, as jy teruggaan na Jesus toe, en jy lees daarvan, en hy sê, once you are dead because of your disobedience and your many sins, you need to live, you used to live in sin, just like the rest of the world, obeying the devil, the commander of the powers in the unseen world. He's the spirit of work in the heart of those who refuse to obey God. And then he carries on to say, but out of our nature, we were subject to God's anger, just like everybody else. But God had grace. Ons kan op God se kwaad gemoed staan maak. You will like it. The wrath of God is heavy. We don't know God. So it gives us the right to be drawn closer. So you say, Peter, what is that right? As ek voel ek is verweg, as ek voel ek is nie waar ek moet wees nie. Close your eyes. Pray and pray, and say, Here, ek is af. Ek is ver weg. Ek wil nie aan die wêreld toegee nie. Ek word ingetrek, ek word weggetrek, ek word in my mind teen mense getorment op hierdie stadium. Ek wil nie so hê nie. Ek vra in die naam van Jesus Christus, maak my vry. En goed wat jou aandag van God aftrek, my vriend, luister na Petrus se dag, loop weg van dit. If it doesn't pick you up, it will tear you apart. If it doesn't build you, it will break you. Walk away from that. Don't become. You see what happens? We get sucked into this thing. But if we receive Christ and today, and He says to us, "Let me go and pay for it," man. There's not even a machine. It's a vending machine. You know what I mean? He just gives it to you. He just wants a yes from us. Let me know. Maar as ek aan mekaar die werk van die wêreld kyk nie ek word die vyand van God aan. Ek is op jou God se kant. So surely I must be the enemy, was it the verkeerde stikkels. You see, if I'm his enemy, because I've become his enemy, Paul was God's enemy, when he by mense so vervolg het. Hy was nie aan die Here se kant nie. Hy het geweet wat is reg. Hy het mense vervolg. Hy was God se vyand. Die ou wat vir jou sê, gaan jy kerk toe. Wat jy nie doen, dit is jou vyand. Die ou wat vir jou sê, jy hoef nie elke Sondag kerk toe te gaan nie. Jy hoef nie dit so te doen nie. Hoor op wat jy hoef nie, dit is jou vyand. Jou enemy kan misschien nie meer different forms in this world today, my friend. An enemy came to us and he found this world with a spirit right now on its knee. This is why the world is in this state. Ons was nie voorberei nie. Mag die Here gee dat as sy koms daar is, ons voorberei sal wees. And that's why we need to look at these things and look at ourselves and say, let's build ourselves. Let's find a place of where we must be. To walk away from this world into the spiritualness of Christ. I do not want to be his enemy. I want to be reconciled to God completely. Colossians 1:20-21 says that through Christ and through him God reconciled everything to himself. He made peace with everything on earth and the earth by means of Christ's blood on the cross. This includes you who were once far away from God. You were his enemies, separated from him. You were evil thoughts and through your evil thoughts and actions. I said it just now. When I'm thinking in the world, I think like the world. In die wereld is, dan is het die wereld. Ek doe soos die wereld. Ek maak saam in die wereld. As ek besluit geneem het, ek is klaar met dit, en ek kom in die situasie, en ek stik in die situasie, en ek is een daar in die ander aan sy spuit in, en sê, maar doen dit, en ek give in to these ouds, I'm still part of the world, I'm not part of Christ. Dit is makkelijk. As jy gesê, ja vir Jesus, dan is dit ja vir Jesus. You see, I want to tell you something this morning, my friend, and this is how it is. When Christ picks you and I up, and he draws us into his family, Christ is royalty. We become royal kings. We become royal kings, but we also become royal family as sons and daughters of Christ. When he sees you, en as ek al die lukke van ons van al die jaren sê, af van my af. En hy picks me up, en hy closes me with dignity, wat hy sê. Jy hou wat die dignity is, en hy closes me, wat hy my aftrek. clothes me with a cloak of loyalty. I simply ask. All my scars. Oor my life. Wat net konings in die troonkamer dra. Especially there for you. For me this morning. That's when he comes and he kicks us up and he rips us with darkness. And he takes us to light. But we've got to show him that we want that. I can read in the old times, Romans 8, verse 68, and see what you do. Our sinful nature will control your life. I just want to skip past that. I want to finish that. I've only used it. Kan ek vir u vra vanoggend voor u Here geken het? Wat was u vir die Here? Was jy sy vyand of was jy soekend? Ek, voor ek tot bekering gekom het, was God sy vyand. Want ek het hom glad nie geherken en enige deel van my lewe nie. Kom uit een baie arm achtergrond uit. Kom uit een achtergrond uit waar mense makkelijk op jy neerkijk. En ek het altijd nog op drie kilo's met het vandag. I never would want to start. Did you say this is so what? It was your right. Probably was. En ek had hy. You remember this, that anything I stand against for God, elke keer as ek op bevraag te hebben, elke keer as ek sê, ach, ek is so te moeg vir hierdie goed, hierdie godsdienste goed, hierdie kerk goed, nie so praat so, what you then do is you take a cloak of royalty and hang it out, what gets taken off for you, and you become the enemy of God. Think about it. En dan gebeur niks reg in die lewe nie. Want waar is die Here dan nou? Want het gaan niks gebeur nie, because you just became his enemy. En til ons nie die vredesgedrag gaan teken, gaan niks vir ons verander. Ons moet besop met eigen hoe ons praat. Ons moet kom tot die beperk. Ons moet so, Charles maak hier en hy sê, we walk parallel as hy. O, daar heb jy kans iets mee. Dit is die ding. As ek en jy met Jesus loop, dan moet ons so doen. As ek en jy nie so loop, dan loop ons so. Sy pad is ek en jy langsom soek. As ons nie langsom loop, soek nie, dan kruis ons ons. We gaan ons ook al sy idee van man. How many of the damn times does that you have in your life? Dit gebeur, baie. Ons eie wil, jonger. Die wereldse wil binnen ons skoppen. Ek wil graag hier. As jy my alles op staan het met jy toe, ek is al beklaan. Maar ons gaan aan die tafel van jy sê dit nog wel. Maar voor ek aan die tafel met God sê, en ek is nie teen om, kan ek nie gebruik. Misunderstand. I want us to, if anything that which is bothering in your life today, we'll leave it as part of our altar call at the end, to fix up before we use. We need to reconcile. If we've moved away by our own conduct, God brought us together this morning to reconcile, to fix up which was taken from us. To reconcile God, we have always been for doubt, and what happened by young, by families and all. It's always a struggle, it's a comment. It's a shame, it's a comment. Hulle kon nie meer teer by mekaar die ense gedagtes was daar in Annie se naam. En toe verdwyn die vrou na 'n ander stad toe en die man is na 'n ander plek toe en hulle het gebly in verskillende plekke. En een dag besluit die ou, hy wil teruggaan na you suck the ball, I use it brokenly. En hy kom in die stad van en hy kyk rond en hy sê, maar ek wil eers by die begraafplaas gestop. Want jy sien, hulle het een kind gehad. Een seentjie. Wat by die jong ouderdom dood is. Toe sê, ek wil net aan die graf toe gaan. Ek wil net gaan kyk wat sy daar was. Toe gaan staan hy by die graf. Sy mens nou by die graf sal staan met jou gedagtes vol. En met eens hoor hy voetstap achter. Het hy omkyk. Dis het sy geliefde vrou. Of die vrou wat hom van vervelend is. Nou, hulle praat nie oor alle goed en behalwe oor die mynde is die dood van die kind. En hoe kom so hulle mekaar by die graf van die sieke kry? Langs toe die kort. Staan sy aan die kant van die graf en aan die kant van die graf. Toe hulle handen vast. Toe reconcilieer hulle. Hulle gebroek die wilik. Maar het die dood van die kind gevat. Omdat die ding. Het is tyd in the days of Christ on the cross. Toe reconcilieer me to God. God gives you the chance this morning to also stand in the grave with this marvelous grace and eternal mercy that He has for us through His Son Jesus Christ. Dat ons volgende kon kom en ons geloof in Jesus. Nothing more and nothing less. Let's put our faith in Jesus because Jesus is faith is the finished work of the cross. The cross never held him down. The grave didn't keep him in. He came walking out. He overcame the works of the devil. Dit is vir jou en vir my beskoring vandag. As op ouwe tyd jy kyk in die Here dan moet ons gesaam, maar ons word nie. There was a guy next to Jesus on the cross. That was clear. Een het hom gespot. En die ander een nie. He said, Lord, would you remember me if you go into paradise? Jesus wants him. King James Version says, verily, verily, I say unto thee that today you will go with me into paradise. Kom. Net omdat jy herken het. Net omdat jy herken het dat Jesus Christus is die enigste weg om in die hemel te kom. Net omdat jy herken het dat Jesus Christus die dood oorwin het, die sonde in hierdie wêreld. Net omdat hy al hierdie ander goede, toe hy siek was, toe hy verloor was, oorwin het. Verlid. Sit voor die Here volgend. Met alles wat ons gebruik volgend. Die Here wil ons kerk gee volgend. Precies diezelfde waar ons mee begin het. Voor ons dit herinner te sê dat ek het hierdie wereld gekom vir jou. Ek ken jou doen en ek ken jou later. Ek weet, jy het weggemaak op een kol. Ek weet wat jy het geval op een kol. En so word het, keer as ons, participate in die pray, Lord, that you bless this bread, deeply into every man, into every woman, into every child of yours this morning. As we take the cup, Father God, and we drink from it, let us acknowledge, Lord, that no, we are not caught up in this world. This morning we want to make a decision and to say, Father, whatever was, was, whatever is, has to be. We want to follow you, Lord. Let your cup. Let your cup in you. Let us dignify you from picking up this cup this morning, Father, and acknowledging that we have been washed clean from sin. Your body is part of our body. Bless this meal. Bless this meeting to every single person, very individually this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. For 3 years, it's a fear of waiting to fight for us. But you see, so many confront on that earth, wondering if I'm so hard. Dit raak moeilijker nou as hulle uitgaan, want jy beskiet het dan, dan raak jy die dag nie van die leer. Maar dan hou net, in jou in die spiegel is vlees, groter is hy, en blijk wat in jou is, en ook oor hy. En my God of Isaac, Abraham en Jacob, ook oor sê, be with you, go with you wherever you are. May he send his angels to guide you, to walk with you, to take you from danger and to bring you into safety. Ach, sy veilig, sy goed uit jou gids, jou volg, waar jy gaan, wat jy sal doen, en wacht jou mond, jou spiel, wat God is.